Hello! Welcome to today's video. My name is Nabilla Fadilla. You can call me Nabilla. I am a student from PR23-EXCL with Sir Charles Bonar, Sirait as my mentor and lecturer in this subject. Today, I would like to talk about two things. The first thing being about public health, and the second thing about our group project. First and foremost, what is public health? Public health, according to the CDC Foundation, is the science of protecting and improving the health of people and their communities. This work is achieved by promoting healthy lifestyles, researching disease and injury preventions, and detecting, preventing, and responding to infectious diseases. Overall, public health is concerned with protecting the health of the entire population. These populations can be as small as your local neighborhood or as big as an entire country or even regions of the world. But why is it important? Well, public health is important because public health professionals try to prevent problems from happening or recurring through implementing educational programs, recommending policies, administering services, and conducting researches, in contrast to the clinical professionals such as doctors and nurses, who primarily focusing on treating individuals after they become sick or injured. Public health also works to limit health disparities. A large part of public health is promoting healthcare equity, quality, and accessibility. In my town, Bontang, public health is distributed nicely, at least that's in my opinion. Let's take the coronavirus vaccine case. Well, at least if we want to call it a case. There are several vaccinations programs held in Bontang in the past few months, or in the entire 2021, from various organizations or institutions or even companies, such as the one being done by the two biggest companies in Bontang, Badak LNG and Pupukaltim, the ones that is held by schools such as YP PDP or YPK or other schools, the ones that is being held by Polres Bontang, and so forth. They are doing this for the workers, medical workers, teachers and their staffs, students, and of course, for the public. With this being said, I do believe that it is pretty clear that public health in Bontang is distributed nicely and evenly, with suppressing and stopping coronavirus in all of our minds and hearts. Now on to the second topic that I would like to talk about, which is our group project. This project is a long-term project in the public speaking and presentation skill class. My group picked the title Persuasive Communication Analysis of Instagram MamaFirst.co in Raising Awareness About Breastfeeding. As our project title, we will be interviewing MamaFirst.co's followers, especially the new moms, and analyze what is the impact of MamaFirst.co's persuasive communication. We chose this topic because it seems interesting for us, and we're excited to do this project. I think that's all for today's video. Thank you for tuning in, and good day.